Let us go on a trip through time and air to Britain and Ireland. Welcome to the Britain and Ireland Pavilion. Today we will be discussing the historical significance and culture of Britain and Ireland. Be sure all carry-on items are securely stowed away. Fasten your seatbelts because we are on our way to Britain. Prior to World War II, Britain suffered a large amount of damage from Germany and other countries. One of the most unforgettable and historical events that happened to Britain was the Blitz. Germany wishes to take over Britain into submission. Despite the many damages that occurred in Britain, the economy and social structure still kept calm and carried on. In the aftermath, Britain suffered. Without the help of the US, the Canadians came in to aid their financial structure plans with their economy and society. After World War II concluded, the National Insurance Act of 1946 provided benefits. They provided insurances for maternity, unemployment, disability, pension, and death. By 1948, Britain established the social welfare programs. Unfortunately, the Empire of Britain has fallen. Many of their territories by 1960s have become independent countries. Besides the war, Britain is known for many other things. To begin with, Britain is known for their cultural practice, their landmarks, and entertainment. Today we will discuss 5 cultural facts that makes Britain prestigious. Number 1. Historical figures. William Shakespeare is known for his literature. He was a man of language arts. He was a man of literature and often puts his plays on the Globe. The Globe was a theater built in 1599. The Globe is now a tourist attraction which hosts all of the old plays. Number 2. Royalty. Britain is home to many castles. Most notably, the Windsor Castle. It is known to be the longest continually inhabited castle and most largest and grand. With many historical bloodlines and events that have happened within and out of Windsor Castle, it is known to have the most historical impact to Britain. The palace is only owned by those who are next to throne, most specifically in modern terms, to those who are born first, such as Queen Elizabeth II. In modern times, the palace is often used for ceremonies. The castle has undergone many renovations throughout the centuries. The castle is composed of many historical architectures. It consists with many family heirlooms and tapestries. One famous heirloom that's been passed down through generations since 1913 was Queen Mary's lover's knot tiara. Many of the previous jewelries that have been passed down through generations, such as the tiara, has been modified to fit modern customs. However, it does not change the fact that there are some fragments of history towards these heirlooms. Number 3. Afternoon tea. It should not be compared to as high tea because this is a social affair dedicated to only eating light meals. It dates back to the 1840s. Traditionally, sandwiches, biscuits such as scones, and pastries are often eaten during these events. These events usually occurred around 4 to 6 p.m. Number 4. The Red Telephone Box. The General Postal Office in 1920 introduced the red telephone box as a way of communication. It was known as the kiosk model or K1. It has been renovated to become K6. It is now used for relics. Number 5. London's Bridge. The bridge was finished in 1894. The bridge covers River Thames. In fact, there is a nursery song named "The London Bridge is Falling Down." Overall, these 5 facts that proves that Britain is a prestigious country influences pop culture. Before we mention the pop culture that happened throughout Britain, here are a few honorable mentions. Before we begin mentioning the pop culture that happened throughout Britain, we would like to make it clear that we will only examine the trends throughout the 40s, 70s, and now. Music is one pop culture that expresses Britain. Throughout the 1950s and now, the music in Britain evolved from jazz to rock to pop during the music era. The origin of jazz occurred in the African culture. The culture uses this genre of music to express love and peace. Moreover, jazz was also fun to dance to. Alma Cogan was also a famous singer during the 1950s in Britain. One of her famous songs was The Birds and the Bees. The Beatles also raged through the 1970s. The genre of rock and roll during the 1970s in Britain was to express political meanings. Whereas today's music, we have Ed Sheeran. Today's music only focuses on pop. Movies were also another factor of pop culture that happened in Britain. There are many genres of movies in Britain. The three most dominant genres in Britain is action, drama, and comedy. The Night and the City was a famous movie that happened in the 1950s. The Railway Children is another movie that was famous in the 1970s. And today we have The Kid Who Would Be King. Moreover, new eras and innovations and inventions have occurred during the 1950s. Television was emerging out in the 1950s. This was a time when audio and visuals were at sync. During the 70s, there was a hippie movement. This movement was inspired by politics, to love and not war. And today we have iPods, which influences audible devices in today's standard. Britain was also known for their sports. However, during the 1940s, when World War II was happening, the Olympics couldn't host any games. Britain and other countries couldn't participate in the Olympics at that time. Most notably, the Britain have so much pride during the 1966 World Cup Games. This game gave Britain most pride for what they have lost in World War II. Today, the recent awards that Britain have got in sports was the Winter Olympics with 5 medals. Back in the day when television came in Britain, not much was being aired. Dad's Army was also a comedic show that happened in the 1970s depicting World War II. Today we have famous Netflix shows such as Black Mirror. It is the time where we have to conclude England's trip. We hope you enjoyed your visit, and now it is time for you to depart to go to Ireland.
January 1942. American troops quartered Northern Ireland. The Americans provide Ireland with supplies such as tanks, firearm, etc. During these times, there was fighting on the streets of Dublin, complete chaos. There was also fighting in the countryside using the farmland to battle. This was one of the most popular TV shows in Ireland. It is called Space Cadets. Another show that everyone enjoyed was the Kennel Show. It was a friendly competition between dogs. In the 1950s, there were many popular movies, like this one, Shamus. It's about a boy that steals a pot of gold from a leprechaun, and the leprechaun gives the boy a monkey's tail. Another very popular movie in Ireland during this time was The Luck of the Irish. This movie is about a man that finds a leprechaun and takes a gold coin from him. Afterwards, the man is offered a job in New York and takes it. Then he gets a servant, which is the same leprechaun, but he does not notice. He ends up getting promoted in his job as boss, and the leprechaun leaves because his secret is found out.
And my undying gratitude. Here, take this little bit of a keepsake to remind you of our meeting.
No, I...
Take it.
Thank you.
No thanks are necessary. It is I that am thanking you from the bottom of my heart. All the...